Good morning, students. In previous session, we learned about the ionization enthalpy. In today's session, we will learn about the electron gain enthalpy. As we know that in ionization enthalpy, what happens? In ionization enthalpy, we add, we remove one electron. And in case of electron gain enthalpy, what happens when we add one electron into the neutral atom or in the elementary atom? There is release of energy and there is somehow addition of energy. We have to gain or we have to release the energy. It is depend to the another different kinds of element. So what is basically electron gain enthalpy? The change, the enthalpy change occurs when a single electron is added into the gaseous state of the element. It means when an element is in gaseous state, it is in the elementary form. What happens when we add one electron in it? It will be changed into the negative ion because one more electron is added into its valence shell. So what happens when we added the electron? It may be there is a depend on the electronic configuration of the element. Sometimes it is very easy to add the electron because they will gain its electronic configuration in its stable configuration. And sometimes we have to add the electron when in a particular element, what happens? It is already in the its stable electronic configuration, so it denies to add the one electron. But we have to add one electron in that condition, we have to get in extra energy. So, in case of different kinds of elements, the electron gain enthalpy are different. But generally, it may be endothermic and exothermic process. Because as I said, it will be depend on the electronic configuration of elements. Just for example, when we added the electron into the 17th group of element in the halogen, chlorine, fluorine, etc. So what happened? Because they have an outer shell electron, it is only 7 electrons. So it needs one more electron to complete its electronic configuration. So what happened? It was one electron will be added in its shell. So it is easy to us for adding the one electron. But when we talk about the group 18 element, what happens? In case of group 18 element, already noble gases have a stable electronic configuration. So that particular electronic configuration does not want to gain the one electron. So in that particular condition, what we have to give extra energy. We have to give the extra energy to take this electron to join the electron in the that electronic configuration. So when the electrons, we have to give the energy in the process of adding the electrons, the process is known as endothermic process. And in this particular case, the higher negative energy will be there. And what is the exothermic reaction? When we have to release the energy, let's say from 18 element, it will have a positive delta H each. So basically what happens, the electron gain enthalpy may be an endothermic process and as well as exothermic process. When we move in the plate, in the what happens in the case of periods and in the group, so as we know that when we move in the left to right in the period, our atomic size will be decreased. And atomic size is decreased, it means nuclear charge, attraction force will be increased. If attraction force is increased, it means it is easy to add the one electron. So when we move from left to right, generally delta HEG, we denote the electron gain enthalpy from the delta HEG, it will be increasing as atomic size decreases and effective nuclear charge, attraction force is increasing. So if attraction force is increasing, it means we easily add the electron in the outermost shell configuration. But in case of group 18, it will be a positive. It means from left to right, it will the value of delta HG is more negative. But in case of delta HG, in case of group 18, it will be a positive. Same when you move in the group from up to down, and we know that size is increasing when we move because the number of shell is increasing. If number of shell increases, size increases, it means the attraction force outermost shell, the valence shell will become very less. So when we add the one electron, it is very difficult because there is less nuclear charge on when we can say less attraction force. So there in particular particular case to add the one electron is very difficult. So we can say that in case of non-metals, generally non-metals have a more negative value of delta Hb. Whereas in case of matter, they have a less negative value of delta Hb because non-metals generally we know that they are the electronegative. So to attain its stable configuration, generally we take more extra electron in their electronic configuration. And in case of metal, we know that it is electropositive. Why they are electropositive? Because to obtain their stable configuration, to complete its octane, they lose the electron. So generally, non-metals have a more negative value and the metals have a less negative value. In the next class, we will learn about the electronegativity of the different elements. Thank you. The next trend in the periodic table is about the electronegativity. It is very important because electronegativity tells about how much electron is attracted in the bonding. When the elements are combined together, they form a bond. They form a they share their electron. So out of the sharing of electrons, which how much power they have attracted? It means one of the elements have a lesser power of to attract the electrons, of the bonded electrons, and some of the elements have a higher power to attract the shared electron. So basically, what is electronegativity or why they are important? Because by the telling or by the study of the electronegativity, we can easily tell that how which of the element have a positive charge, partial positive charge, or partial negative charge in the particular compound. And when we learn about that, it is very easy for us to learn about, to explain about the different chemical reactions. So, to proceed with the different chemical reaction in the further chapter, it is very important we know about the electronegativity. So, what is electronegativity? Simple, as I told you, it is a qualitative measure. It means it is not a quantitative. It cannot actually, it is measured in the numbers. It is a qualitative. It means it is a comparatively measurement of the elements of the characteristics. So, simple or qualitative measure of the ability of an atom. It is the ability of an atom in a compound to attract shear electrons. It means how much atom is attracted to a shear electrons towards himself or towards itself. This is known as electronegativity. Just for example, if we calculate, how can we calculate the electronegativity? As I already told you, if this particular electronegativity is not a quantitative measurement, it is a qualitative. It means the exact value of electronegativity cannot be measured. So, but there are different practical value or different skills are there to calculate the sum electronegativity of the elements, which is Pauling scale and Millikan's web scale, which is generally used. There is another one also, but these two are majorly used to measure the calculation of the electronegativity of the element. One is Pauling scale and Millikan's web scale. Out of these, Pauling and Millikan most used is Pauling scale. Okay. Now, if we move in the period, what is the effect of the electronegativity? And if we move in the groups, in the periodic table, what is the effect of the electronegativity? So basically, when we move into the left to right in the periodic table, our electronegativity is increasing. It means when we compare the second shell, for example, lithium, barium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, so as we move from left to right, electronegativity is increasing. It means oxygen has a highest electronegativity than the nitrogen, and nitrogen has a high carbon. As when we move in the group, electronegativity decreases. It is decreased, that means here in the first group, lithium is there, lithium, nitrogen, potassium are there. If you compare potassium and nitrogen, the potassium has a less electronegativity than the potassium, and because as we move, electronegativity is decreasing. Why does it decrease and why it increases? It is simply related to gain capability is increasing. Electron gaining of capability of element, when the element is increasing, it means it will be attracting the electrons to itself. Or we know that electronegativity is what? It is a shading off to attract the shield electron. It means as the electron gain enthalpy or increases, we can say non-metallic character is increases, electronegativity is also increases. Why it is so? Because non-metals are easily gain the electrons. It means they easily attract the electrons. And electronegativity inversely proportional to the metallic character, because metals are the electropositive. They want the electron will remove from its outermost shell. It means they have a lesser electronegativity. Remove means they are not attracting the electron. So simple electronegativity can be measured by these two parameters also. It is directly proportional to the non-metallic character. It means as non-metallic character increases, electronegativity of the element is also increases. And if metallic characters are increases, electronegativity is increases. Just for example,